we spent a lot of time kind of collaborating together on what are the best vignettes to both highlight the car, which is one of the main characters in the story, as well as the dad and the baby and, you know, just the pleasure center of the spot. Where are you enjoying it? Where are you feeling most engaged in the commercial?
You forgot the Binky?
I forgot the Binky!
Tragic. Hashtag Binky Dad.
I am David Angelo, and I'm chairman and founder of David and Goliath.
My name is Damion Clayton. I'm an editor at Rock, Paper, Scissors.
I'm Russell Wager, the vice president of marketing for Kia America.
Talk to us a little bit about the ideation process that you went through with David and Goliath.
The brief was very simple. We wanted to make sure that people that saw this spot first took away that it was capable. When you're going to talk to over 100 million people, in one moment, you want to make sure that the majority of them can relate to it and engage with it.
The whole world is watching this dad trying to race back to get a baby, and that felt very adorable. I have two kids. I've been through that. So it was a relatable story as well as a really adorable story.
He's a regular guy with a family, and he's got a situation that he needs to solve quickly. So we wanted the Telluride to help him be the hero to the family.
We didn't really focus on a specific audience per se, but more of a mindset. Throughout the campaign, they're all rooting for each other in many ways. When you look at the audience, the people that are watching this man conduct his journey, they too are the audience. Even the music is the audience. Everyone is rooting for the spirit of the underdog.
And we spent a lot of time trying to figure out that balance between here's a dad who's forgotten the Binky, here's a wife that is telling the husband to get the Binky, but there's this baby, and you really wanted to kind of feel all those different elements.
One of the things that is most interesting about this Super Bowl spot is just how overarching the strategy really is.
We don't set out to create a Super Bowl spot per se, but a Super Bowl experience. And that experience comes down to the art of storytelling and on multiple levels, multiple platforms, with different audience who all embrace the Tomorrow Seeker mindset. And we just want to make sure that that story is told through many different, you know, channels. And not just the week before, 2 weeks before the Super Bowl and then 2 weeks after, but really it's about the entire year.
You do a Super Bowl spot to tell one of two things. Either you're launching a product, or you're telling them something about the brand that you want them to remember, not just for the next 30 days, but you want them to remember for the rest of the year.
This year, you're taking it to TikTok with three alternate endings and then some influencer collaborations. Why the alternate endings?
I'm sure there are a lot of Binky stories that moms and dads and even aunts and uncles and all kinds of people can tell. And so we thought, why not keep the story going? And so we shot these alternate endings. One was he comes into the house to retrieve the Binky.
He goes back, he walks in, and right there on the counter is a note that says, "Don't forget this." And it's the blue Binky that he forgot.
One of them was when he comes into the door, he goes to get the Binky, he opens up the drawer, and there's like 100 blue Binkies. Being the dad that he is, he picks up the whole drawer and takes it with him.
He sees one of those Roomba robots about to suck up the Binky that's on the floor. All of those are real things, and that's what we wanted to make sure, is that people can imagine themselves doing this. It's not fake, it's not too far out, and they'll probably never do those things, but they could if they wanted to.
We wanted to, you know, kick it off and show consumers what they can do to create their own Binky endings.
We had almost 19 million people watch the three endings. It's not the 113 million that see in the Super Bowl, but there's an awful lot of conversation that continues before and after.
I heard this phenomenal anecdote about how you actually jumped the car twice and it received only cosmetic damage.
Everything the vehicle did, it did. It's not CGI. So when you see it going down the ski run, when you see it jumping through the cylinder and the construction dike, it's doing it all in real time.
This was pretty awesome to watch. It took, I think it was two jumps. I mean, you never know what's going to happen when you try something like this. But aside from a couple scrapes, it handled really well. And we did the second jump as precaution.
It really became a question of how do we exacerbate the speed at which the car feels like it's exiting the tube, and then highlight the beauty of the car. When the car landed and that close-up, when we go back to real speed, I believe that was the real tightening of the screw to make that scene work.
Do you think that in the future, most brands, or if not all brands, are going to need to have some sort of interactive element embedded in their Super Bowl spot?
If they're not, they're going to get lost. Gone are the days of just doing a one-off Super Bowl spot. I mean, you really have so many great tools now that give you opportunities to take that message and share that message and really expand the storytelling experience.